Good afternoon, pilot teachers and students, and good afternoon, class.
Good afternoon, Mr. Sarimon.
All right, thank you. You may sit down. All right, this time we will look at one type of potential energy, and that is the elastic potential energy. All right, can somebody give us an explanation? All right, this time, Isaac, you tell us what is elastic potential energy.
Energy stored in spring.
Energy that is?
Stored in an elastic substance.
Okay, good. So looking at this, we can assume that elastic potential energy will be the energy that is stored in any elastic substance, such as a rubber band or let's say a coil spring or any other spring. All right. I will now ask you to tell me exactly what you feel from those. Okay, Joe, you will have to tell us what you feel, especially when you are playing around with that rubber band. Okay, where is the spring? Jolene, you will tell us what you feel, especially when you are pulling or stretching that coil spring. Okay, Joe.
There is a, as I'm pulling it and it's stretching, there is a force that is acting toward and bringing the object back to its original.
Okay, so when he's stretching the rubber band, he can feel a force that is almost pulling his hand towards. Okay, where he started from. Okay, you tell us what you can feel, especially when you stretch that.
It's kind of the same as the rubber band. There's also a force in the center pulling the springs back.
So you mean the force is now pulling your hand towards where you started. Okay, good. From this two explanation, you can see that the elastic potential energy or elastic stored energy, especially on the spring, is trying to push something in. All right, when you stretch that, it will either pull it back in. If you press that, for example, I have a, what do we call this one? You tell me what you. I'm pushing it and it comes back. So you'll find that it can be either pushing or pulling force on any one of those elastic substances. There is always an opposite force that is always trying to go against the forces, okay, whether it is pushing or pulling. All right, so quickly go through, pilot teachers, may you ask your students to go through and have this definition down quickly. I want you to follow through. I will now go through giving you only the notes. There won't be any explanation. Following these notes, I want you to do some questions. So, pilot students, please observe carefully as this will be going to, as I'm going through the slides. The notes will be given to you. Just copy that, and then after the end of these notes, there will be a few questions based on the topic. All right, shall we move on?
Yes.
Yes?
Yes.
Okay, moving on to diagram showing you what you have copied in the first slide, or let's say the second slide. All right, there is a spring there, and then the hand is pulling, meaning that it is the action. And then you find that the spring is trying to pull that hand in. In other words, this would be the reaction. But we will find that this action and reaction must always be equal, but they are opposite. This one, I'm applying a force, and I can feel that there is a force that is trying to pull my hand in. If I just relax, all right, then probably the hand will move in. So there is opposite forces. They are equal in size, so probably magnitude, but direction is quite different. Okay, one is opposite to another one. Okay, quickly sketch that diagram. All right. If you want to use a graph to explain that, simply you find the extension against load or the distance against the force. Okay, that is from, there is a certain time when, okay, in our lessons on force and pressure, you may have studied the elastic force. Okay, the elastic force is simply the force that is either pushing in the opposite direction, and it can be given from that. Now, there is a certain time when the force will go to its limit, and when you apply the force, and when the force is greater than that elastic force, it will either snap or break off, or sometimes it comes to a point where we call that as an elastic limit. Okay, you may have learned from our last lessons the elastic limit for metal, and there will be elastic limit for rubber band as well. And each one of those elastic limit will be facing in different directions. If it is a rubber band, it will be facing downwards. If it is for, let's say, a metal, that elastic limit will be facing upwards. All right, you have this diagram already. This is just an explanation of from our last lessons, okay? Moving on to how we can, or you can find the work. Okay, force equals to, okay, minus kx, because when you are applying the force, this elastic constant is a constant in the spring that will always try to pull your hand, and this is measured in newton meter. And then when you have to have this work equals to minus fx, and then you get this, if you want to find a work equals to half times kx square. All right, why do we have that? Initial and the final. Okay, before you start stretching that spring, and also after. So there are two positions in which you apply the force. So you get this one as half kx square. Okay, so that is how you can work out the force on, or let's say the work that is done by these elastic substances. Are you finished? Okay. Copy that equation quickly. Because it is moving in the opposite direction. Okay, minus F. Yeah. Yeah, that is the reaction. Okay, so using that, when you have to. All right, just get that quickly and then there will be questions given to you. All right, a very quick question. Why do we have this one as minus? Minus is because of the opposite force that is always pulling towards. So the work done is simply equal to half kx squared. Why do we have this one? All right, since we have work equals to force times distance. And then when you have this, you have this is the spring constant, and that x will be in the distance or in meters. Okay. This constant is given by Newton per meter. So when you cancel this, it gives you this Newton. All right, so that is for the constant, and then you multiply that. When you multiply this one, that will be that force times x. Okay, k given is here. Okay, times this m, which is for this one. Okay, so when you multiply that, you arrive with k times this, which is x for this, and then square. Okay. That is why we arrive with work equals to half kx squared. All right, for question two, are there questions that will... Have you finished? Here are the questions. Okay, listen carefully. Before you go on to answering those questions, you have just taken down or sketched the graph. Now, if you want to find a work that is done, since you have force against extension graph, the work done will be area under the graph, okay? The area of the graph is simply the work done. How do you find the area of a triangle? Half base times height. So in this case, you find that the base will be What is the base in this case? Okay, from your diagram, it is the distance, and then the height would be force. Okay, from that equation, how base times height, you can calculate that to give you the work that is done. That is from the graph. So question one is how much work is done in stretching the spring? 0.2 meters, okay? Quickly copy the question. If you don't know what you will do, okay, raise your hands for help. Pilot students, if you need help, please raise your hand so that your teacher will help you to answer those questions. Finish. You okay? Are you okay with that question? Right, question two. Okay, this one is simply the force, Newton. Yeah. That's right. Don't escape. Minus K is just telling you how when you apply that, but our final equation will be given from the last, which is work equals to kx half kx squared. Minus k is telling us the force that is always pulling our things. Okay. Force, the one you said, just half force times distance, okay. Half force, which is K times, because how did you find a K? Which is times square. Question activity two, that is activity two. please sketch the diagram quickly, and then I will give you two more questions on that. This is just telling you, because when you have a line, you know from the elastic limit it will go, because it will be proportional, okay, it will be proportional. If that is increasing, it will also increase, so from there you will come out this way. How do you find the work that is done 2 meters? That is the area under equal, and that is how A is times height, because in here this is just giving you, you see, you will only calculate this area. Extension is 4, and then this is the area that you will have to calculate, not this one. You see?
But it asks for the work. So the work is the area.
Area. Okay. Area under the graph. Okay. Some of you are making mistake. Now, for this, if you can look up, please. For our first question, we have a force that is running in that direction, and then you have the extension. Okay. It is not the area of this one. From that, you will find that there is always a line that is running through straight this way. So, you will have to consider this area. Okay. When you are calculating the area of a triangle, what do you use? Half base times height. It is the same thing. Half kx squared. Okay? So it is only asking you to calculate this area, not this one. Okay, this one, no. This is the area that you will calculate. Because extension will be proportional to the, okay, it will be proportional to the force. Okay, extension is proportional to the force. That is why you will have a line that is running straight. Okay, when it increases, this one will also increase. That is why you have a line that is running through, and then you calculate this one. There is no work done on this. It is just showing you the distance, okay? It is a free spring constant. This is a force of spring constant that is trying to. Okay, you see how we solve that spring constant? Okay, so spring constant is simply the force that is pulling in opposite direction. Okay. Yeah. It is a force. It's a bell cone. Yes or no? Yes. All right, these are the two final questions. activity two on based on craft two. I will just give you these questions and I will give you some time to go through and come up with the questions, right? Not in a lesson, but it will be given to you as a homework. So I want you to go through, write those questions down, and then you, in your own time, you try those questions and then we'll have a look at the answers in our next lesson. Finish copying your question. Have you finished copying the question? Okay. Listen, I will now go through and then give you a summary of the lesson. Those questions, the four questions from those two activities, right, one and two, I want you to go through and then do them as your homework, and we'll have a look at the answers in our next lesson. All right, basically to sum up what we discussed in the lesson, elastic potential energy, or in other words, stored energy of a spring, or let's say a rubber band or coil, can sometimes do work. Right? If you are trying to calculate the force, force is always these opposite and equal forces acting on the spring. Sometimes when you pull, you'll find that your hand will be almost pushed towards the place where you started pulling. So there is an equal force that is always acting opposite, but direction is quite different. So from there, we can use to calculate the work. Now, if you can remember from our last lessons on the topic, which is on force and pressure, you learned something on the elastic force, okay? Because there is an extension and the force applied. We sometimes have this constant or the spring constant which is trying to push the force or pull your hand or whatever forces in the opposite direction. That is why we come up with the force as minus kx. Or in general, we can say that our force is work done can be given as force times distance, and you have that, or we can say half kx squared. Okay, half kx squared. That will give you the work done, okay, from our equation. So I will now stop here for pilot students. I know you will have some difficulties, especially with this topic. Please do go through, read through, or if you can attempt some questions, especially from other sources, you can consult your teacher if you don't fully understand what I've just gone through. And also for you motor students, I'd like you to go through and complete this one. If you have any questions, please do come back and then see me so that we can discuss those questions. All right, so that brings us to the end of the lesson. And our key phrase will be, elastic potential energy. Good afternoon, pilot teachers and students, and good afternoon, class.
Good afternoon, Mr. Sarayman.
All right, thank you. You may sit down.